Did you know former James Bond actor Pierce Brosnan once narrated for Thomas the Tank Engine? In 2008, a special movie based on the successful children's show, based on the successful series of books dating all the way back to the 40s, titled Thomas and Friends: The Great Discovery, was narrated by Brosnan, who was familiar with the series for many years already and would often read them to his own children.
Gordon didn't want to pick up the workmen. He wanted to pick up the very important passengers.
I've got to get coal and water. See you at Great Waterton, Gordon. And Stanley chuffed cheerily away.
Brosnan was, of course, overjoyed to be part of a long line of narrators for the TV series, including, of course, former Beatles member Ringo Starr. During pre-production of the first season of Thomas, producer Britt Allcroft heard Ringo's voice on the TV and immediately thought of him to record the narration for the show. Ringo agreed and recorded the first season of the show over the course of about 8 days. Some re-recording was necessary, both for his voice being a little gruff early in the morning, but also to redo certain lines specifically for the American release of the show, where certain terminology was different.
Gordon was very cross. Instead of nice shining coaches, he was pulling a very dirty freight train. A freight train! Edward laughed and went to find some more freight cars.
Gordon was very cross. Instead of nice shining coaches, he was pulling a lot of very dirty trucks. A goods train! Edward left and went to find some more trucks.
In line with wanting to introduce an American audience to the British-created series, a live-action TV series called Shining Time Station, starring Didi Khan of Grease fame, was created alongside the series and featured two episodes of Thomas the Tank Engine, interspersed between the episodes. The stories were told to the young kids by a magical character from the world of Thomas the Tank Engine, the island of Sodor, named Mr. Conductor, played by, you guessed it, Ringo Starr. Ringo filmed the first season's worth of Shining Time Station episodes, while in the UK, he had been recording the second season of Thomas and Friends. However, in the early 90s, Ringo Starr departed from the production and was replaced by a new narrator, the late great comedy legend George Carlin, who wanted audiences of his more adult work to see a different side of him. George took over the part of Mr. Conductor for the rest of the Shining Time Station series, up to the mid-90s, and recorded not only the new third and fourth seasons, but also went back and re-recorded the first two seasons originally done by Ringo with the American script.
Thomas the Tank Engine was feeling bright and cheerful. It was a splendid day.
Meanwhile, in England, Michael Angelis took over for the narration starting from season 3 and continued voicing for the series all the way up to the 16th season. This makes Angelis the longest-running narrator of the show.
Thomas the Tank Engine was feeling bright and cheerful. It was a splendid day.
Oh, and a little side note. His older brother, Paul Angelis, also just so happened to voice the cartoon version of Ringo Starr in the animated movie The Yellow Submarine, along with George Harrison and the Blue Meanie. Back in the U.S., starting from season 5, was Academy Award-nominated actor Alec Baldwin, who carried on to the 6th season and was most notably featured in the first Thomas the Tank Engine feature film, Thomas and the Magic Railway, as the Shining Time Station character, Mr. Conductor.
Percy had been working at the docks all day and was tired of the smell of fish. Phew, come on, Percy, said his driver. Time to go home.
This movie also featured Didi Khan returning as her Shining Time Station character, Stacey Jones, along with former child actress Mara Wilson and even Academy Award winner Peter Fonda. To the young fans of the show, on the other hand, what was most notable about this movie was that this was the first time the Thomas the Tank Engine characters would have their own unique voices in English. The Magic Railway film went through several halts in production over the course of many years before its eventual release in the summer of 2000. Most interesting was that several key characters were voiced by different actors in the earlier drafts of the film, before the new character voices were eventually recorded in Toronto, Canada. Thomas himself was meant to be played by fireman and part-time taxi driver John Bellis, who happened to pick up producer Britt Allcroft from the airport, and once again, upon hearing his voice, immediately thought, that's the voice of Thomas. A small sample of Bellis' performance can be heard in an early trailer for the film.
Well, who else were you expecting? Don't worry, I'm on my way. I'll save a seat for you.
Unfortunately, due to test audiences finding Thomas's voice too old-sounding, Bellis was replaced by Canadian actor Edward Glenn, who, along with a few of his fellow voice actors, portrayed several of Thomas's friends with English accents in tribute to their British heritage.
Who else were you expecting? Don't worry, I'm on my way! I'll save a seat for you!
A similar case occurred with the movie's lead villain, Diesel 10, played originally by Australian actor Keith Scott, using a gravelly, upper-class British accent.
Losing your sparkle, eh? What perfect timing!
He was eventually replaced by the less scary-sounding Neil Crone, who, along with his improv partner Kevin Frank, did numerous characters in the film. Crone initially did a Russian accent for Diesel 10, but once again was found too scary and possibly offensive early on, so it was re-recorded with more of a New York accent.
I'll get you, you blue puffball!
Speaking of scary, there was also a human character cut from the final film shortly before its release. P.T. Boomer, played by Doug Lennox, a voiceover artist who's worked in radio for 40 years. There was also Britt Allcroft herself, voicing a new and important steam engine character, Lady. And an ironic twist of fate in that the fourth installment of the Harry Potter book series, The Goblet of Fire, released the day before Thomas and the Magic Railway had its release in the UK. Harry Potter himself, Daniel Radcliffe, would later portray a parody version of Thomas in an episode of the Adult Swim series, Robot Chicken.
Bust my buffers! This isn't the way to the Whistling Woods!
Harold the Helicopter! You're a part of this!
Another tribute to the original series that was unfortunately dropped was Michael Angelis, originally set to play Percy and James. But, like Thomas, Michael's recordings were replaced by younger-sounding character voices. So young, in fact, that they were actually played by women doing little boy voices.
Oh, Thomas! I've been worried about you. Bertie says you lost a coal truck today.
You weren't concentrating, Thomas. Lucky for you that the buffers were there.
These two actresses, Linda Ballantyne and Susan Roman, you might recognize from the popular anime series Sailor Moon, as the voices of the original Deke-produced English dub of the series Sailor Moon and Sailor Jupiter, respectively. Oh, and speaking of anime, starting from the 13th season onward, the Thomas and Friends series switched to CG animation instead of using model trains and clay faces. It also began using the Magic Railroad's tradition of using individual voice actors for the characters, along with the narrator. The show has since been utilizing a variety of actors and narrators over the years, including several that are different between the American and British releases of the show. However, in Japan, Thomas the Tank Engine's Japanese dub has used this tradition since the very beginning, with narrator Leo Morimoto, the second longest-serving narrator behind Michael Angelis, and unique voice actors for each character, some of which you might recognize from certain anime series, such as Katsuji Mori, Atlas from Astro Boy, Nail from Dragon Ball Z, Jean-Pierre Polnareff from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, and Ken the Eagle from Gatchaman, as the voice of James. Hikaru Midorikawa, voice of Hiro Yui from Gundam Wing, Android 16 from Dragon Ball Z, Marth from Fire Emblem, and Zelgadis Greywords from Slayers, as the voice of Bertie the Bus. And Keiko Toda, voice of classic 80s anime series Anpanman's title character, on the part of Thomas. Finally, circling all the way back to the beginning, in 2009, a special animated music video for the BBC Children in Need charity featured a whole host of characters from successful children's shows, all singing together for the official BBC Children in Need medley. This, of course, featured Thomas himself, and performing him for this massive musical number was none other than Ringo Starr, the original narrator brought back over 20 years after recording the series. Thanks for watching. This video was inspired by Did You Know Gaming, so go check out their channel and watch all their videos about gaming trivia. Special thanks to Omahdon for the audio mastering, Sudri and Afro for the music, and BehindTheVoiceActors.com and Sodor Island for all the audio samples and research. If you like this video, go check out some of our other ones on the side, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want more. See you next time.